Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15 Beta 2. This is available to developers and hopefully very soon to public beta testers. Apple has said that should be coming in July, or based on their WWDC keynote, they said next month, which would put that in July. Sometimes it does come out a little bit early though. And the first thing is, this came in at 1.52 gigabytes. That's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and I also have it on the iPhone 11. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15 Beta 2 that I have on my 12.9 inch iPad Pro, the M1 version, along with WatchOS 8 Beta 2 and tvOS 15 Beta 2. They did not release macOS Monterey Beta 2 just yet. Also, something else worth noting is if you're trying to install iPadOS 15 Beta 2, it isn't available for the iPad Pro 9.7 inch Wi-Fi and cellular model for some reason. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. You can see the build number is 19A5281H. And this particular build brings a lot of resolved issues. There's still some known issues we'll talk about a little bit later, as well as some new features and more. And the first thing is a new updated modem firmware. So there's new modem firmware in this update. So maybe you were having 5G connectivity issues. Hopefully it resolves some of those issues for the early betas. Now, the first new feature, and thanks to a few different people that helped me out with this, Steve Mosier, Matt, and others, the first thing is you might see here, Maps. The Maps icon has been updated. And here I'm running Beta 1. This is on the iPhone 6S Plus. And you can see here's the old map icon. There's the new map icon. So that's been updated. It's not a huge change, but it's something to note. Now also, focus modes have been updated as well. So if we go into Settings, and then we'll go back here, we'll go to Focus. Under Focus, maybe you already set up a focus mode. Go into that focus mode, and under focus mode, it says home screen and lock screen. Under home screen, there's now your custom pages. It shows which custom pages you have available, and then you can edit those pages, what you want to show when you're using that specific focus mode. And so that's something that's been updated as well, and you can change them right from here. And then if we go back, it now says lock screen. Prior to this, it just said option. So it says lock screen, show on lock screen, and dim lock screen. So as I change from, say, maybe that focus mode to a different one, maybe home evening, you'll see the home screen is a little bit different and there's only two selected. So they've updated that as well. Now, another change with focus mode has to do with the control center do not disturb button. So if you go into the control center, on the left, I have beta 1, on the right, I have beta 2 of iOS 15, press and hold or 3D touch on do not disturb. And you'll see at the top, it's a little bit different. On the left, it says stay focused on what's important. The new version says find focus in the day, filter notifications, signal to friends when you're not available, and hide distractions without missing what's important. On the left, it has you create a focus. So it's a little bit different and they've changed this up. Now they may bring it back for the first time to what we have with beta 1 and then change it after it's available in beta 2, but it's a small change they've made in beta 2. Now another change they've made has to do with wallpapers. So if we go into settings and then we go to wallpaper, under wallpaper, if we go to choose a new wallpaper and under choose a new wallpaper, you'll see it says stills. Under stills, if we go into our stills and we tap on a wallpaper to select it, you'll see it says loading. That's something that's new, just letting you know that the wallpaper is loading. Before it just seemed like a long delay. Now it says loading to give you an idea that it's still doing something, but it just hasn't processed that yet. So it's a small change there. Now within the Watch app, they've made an update as well. So if you have WatchOS 8, you're running the beta, and we'll go to the Watch app, and then we go to the Face Gallery, you'll now see that portraits are available. This wasn't available with beta 1, but it's available in beta 2. So you can see it on your iPhone or watch with iOS 15 beta 2 or WatchOS 8 beta 2. So now you can go through those new portrait modes. Now the next thing they've updated is the first time you open weather, there's a new splash screen. So if you open up weather, you'll see it says weather maps, notifications, and new design, explore precipitation, air quality, and temperature maps, as well as get notified when rain or snow is starting or stopping, and view new weather charts, animated backgrounds, and more. So that's new the first time you open weather. Also, the first time you open notes, there's another splash screen. So once you open notes, it says organize with tags, mentions and shared notes, and activity view. So again, it's just showing you what's new, but you can organize with tags and there's shared notes and activity view. I explained a lot more of this in the beta 1 video and went more in depth, but it's just explaining those features that were already there. Now, a feature that Apple talked a lot about in their WWDC keynote about iOS 15 has to do with SharePlay. That's now enabled in iOS 15 beta 2. So if we go to settings and then we go down to FaceTime, so find FaceTime, tap on FaceTime. If you scroll down, you'll see that it says SharePlay. It says watch shows, listen to music, and use apps together during FaceTime calls. Tap on that, and now you have the option to turn it on or off. If it's on, you're good to go. If you want to share music or movies together when you're on a FaceTime call. So I'll place a FaceTime call to myself and the FaceTime call is running. It says waiting for others. If I tap on this, it now says share link grid layout. So this has changed a little bit, but if I hit done and then I go out of this and then go into music, it will now ask me to share play music. And it says with, so you can share that with someone else. And all you need to do is start playing it to share. The same thing is true as if you go into TV, for example. So if we go into the TV app, you'll see that it pops down and says SharePlay TV with. And so if you have someone else with iOS 15 beta 2, you can share this with them. And 9to5 Mac actually has a little updated version of this that they showed where they were able to try it out. So as you can see here, the menu has changed a little bit. So they've updated that where you can just share play those different things, where there's a little pop-up as well to help you share play that. So that's something they've updated with iOS 15 beta 2. Now, another thing they've changed is under settings. If we go to settings, then accessibility, scroll down a little bit. If we go on beta 1, I can show you side by side. We'll go down to accessibility, scroll down to AirPods. The icon has been updated from AirPods Pro on the left to the AirPods Max on the right. If we go into AirPods, tap on one of the AirPods, you'll see that we now have the option for follow iPhone. This is for spatial audio, so you can have it follow your iPhone. So maybe you have the headphones in, you're listening to music or TV, you can move your head and it'll sound like the audio is coming from the iPhone. So you have the option to turn that on or off now, and it's by device. So AirPods Pro, for example, follow iPhone, and maybe you want it off for AirPods Max, turn that off. So that's a new option as well. Now within health, there's some changes as well. So if we go into health, under health, go to browse, under browse, go to mobility, and we have walking steadiness. Now we knew about this before, but you can set this up. And then under that is an article about mobility. Now understanding walking steadiness was there before, but it's been updated with a new image, for example, and some of this has changed. So that has been updated. Also, if you go to sharing, the new health sharing feature is now available. And it says you're in control. Keep friends and family up to date on how you're doing by securely sharing your health data. Now, of course, this is opt-in and you can share this or you don't have to. And then there's dashboard and notifications, and it tells you that it's private and secure. So this is available now and active in iOS 15 beta 2. Now within mail, they've made a slight change as well, where it says unsubscribe. They've made a change back to what this looked like before. Prior to this, it had a little bit different design to it. Now you can unsubscribe from a mailing list, and it looks like it did pretty much with iOS 14, for example. Within messages, there's been some updates as well. And the update has to do with Memoji. And under Memoji, they've added all of the different things they said they were going to with iOS 15. So we have new headwear, for example. There's new eyewear. So there's some star glasses here as well. And there's a bunch of changes to everything from eyewear. There's some new star glasses. And then also we have clothing now. So if you want to update your Memoji with clothing, we can change that and you'll have clothing here. And those are new in iOS 15. Apple talked about over 40 different changes with this, and now they've brought them to this. So we have different headwear. Like I said, if you scroll down through here, you'll see all sorts of changes and new eyewear and more. So that has all been updated in iOS 15 beta 2. Again, they talked about this before, but they didn't bring it here until now. Now Apple has brought a new feature, Private Relay, to iCloud Plus. This is available on iOS 15. And if we go into our settings, tap on our name, under iCloud, you'll see that it says Private Relay. These used to be at the top, so now they've just integrated them into the menu. And if we go into Private Relay, under Private Relay, it takes a moment to load. So we'll wait for it to load here. There we go. And then it says IP address location. If we tap on this, we now have options. Before it wouldn't really do anything, but now it says maintain general location and use country and time zone. So this is now working, and it says you can keep using your general IP address location so that websites can provide local content in Safari, or you can choose to use a broader IP address location in your country and time zone. So that's been updated in iOS 15 beta 2 as well. Now within the Shortcuts app, there's a change as well. So if we go into Shortcuts, tap on create a new shortcut, and then you have the little menu button in the upper right. Tap on this and you'll see receive what's on screen. This is a new option. We'll tap this and turn it on, go back to done. And now you have receive any input from what's on the screen. This works just like Siri works, for example. So you have that option, tap on what's on the screen, and then you just have the options you had before. So it's nice that they've added this, and they continually update Shortcuts, and they have a lot more with this along with macOS Monterey with scripting and more. So they've really pushed hard with Shortcuts and bringing more and more to it, I think is what we'll see in the future. I'm sure we'll see more as betas go on. Now, another change has to do with home. So if you have a HomePod or a HomePod mini, we'll press and hold, and then we'll go down to the settings. No longer is the option for lossless audio available. This has been removed, and maybe it will be brought back later, as it said that the lossless music will be on HomePod, but right now it's gone. So maybe they'll bring it back with a future update. So it's a small change there as well. Now within Photos, they've made a slight change as well. So if we go into Photos, under For You, you'll see that Memories are now on top and then Featured Photos below. In beta 1, Featured Photos were on the top and then Memories were below. So it's just a small change there that's been updated in iOS 15 beta 2. Now, there's some other changes that I wanted to share with you on iPadOS 15 as well. So let's switch over to the iPad. Now on iPadOS 15, one of the changes that they've made is something they mentioned with the keynote, but it wasn't available before. Now you may already be familiar with a quick note where you slide in from the corner and you can bring in a quick note. Now you can use your finger to bring that in. Before you couldn't do this, you can move it around and then bring it out and slide it out. So now you can use your finger if you don't have an Apple Pencil. That's working as it should be. It's sensing that movement. So that gesture is working for a quick note. That's something that's new on iPad. Another thing that's new is there's a new widget. So maybe we'll go into our widgets here. We'll add a new one. On the left-hand side, you can see all of the widgets you would expect are there now for iPadOS, and there's a new larger music widget as well. So we can add this widget, and then we have a large music widget if we want that on our home screen. So that's something they've updated as well. Now with iPadOS 15 Beta 2, there's a couple changes that are there if you're using a trackpad, a mouse, and a keyboard with your iPad. So I have a Magic Keyboard attached to the iPad, and if I go into Messages, within Messages, if I tap a contact, you'll see it puts a little blue box around it. And that works on any of the different conversations I have. So as you can see, there's a little blue box. It's a minor change, but it disappears if I remove the keyboard. So it's just a small little change to help you if you want to use the keyboard and mouse. The other change they've made if you're using a mouse or trackpad is if you go into Safari, if maybe you're on a website, say apple.com, and you bring your mouse cursor up into the address bar, there's now a refresh button. So you can see it there. Now the refresh button's there and it doesn't show up if I remove, say, the keyboard and mouse or trackpad. It just disappears. So that's a small change in iPadOS. Now within iOS 15 beta 2, there are a ton of resolved issues. According to Apple's notes, there's over 70 resolved issues, from everything to private relay, widgets, the app library, drag and drop, FaceTime fixes, search, guided access issues, health, errors with Siri, for example, mail, notes, photos, Safari, and more. However, with all of those different things that are fixed, as well as the wideband connectivity and things like that, those are all resolved. However, there's still 64 known issues, or 64 or 65 known issues that are still in this particular update. So there's definitely issues that are still not resolved. Apple works on these every time, and they really knock out bugs as they can and as it is sort of on their priority list. So there's still more to be fixed in this, but so far it seems to be pretty good as far as overall stability. Now it's only been out a couple hours, so I haven't used it for days at this point, but it seems to be okay. And as far as overall battery life, I know many of you will ask me that, and the only thing we can do is wait a few days to see how it is. Generally, you want to wait about a day or two to have everything stabilize and then see how your battery is with normal use. So I can show you with beta 1 since we've been running that for a couple weeks, and my battery health finally dropped down to 99% even before beta 1. So the updates don't affect battery health, it's just rechecking, but after using this every day, plugging it in every night and charging all night long, since say last year at this point, or last September, October, this has been my main phone and it's only down to 99%. 80% after 2 years is normal. And so as you can see, we'll take a look at yesterday. I used it for 3 hours and 30 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 24 minutes of screen off time. Today, so far, 3 hours and 13 minutes and 1 hour and 33 minutes of screen off time. So depending on the day, it varies. Generally, I'll get through a day with about 50% left before I go to bed and probably about 8 hours of screen on time, maybe 6 to 8. And it hasn't been great with beta 1, but this is an early beta, so we don't expect battery to be the focus just yet. However, performance seems to be pretty good. On older devices, whether that be beta 1 or beta 2, some people are saying that performance is much better than beta 1 already on older devices. So it seems to be okay. Swiping is really all we can do on these older devices to see how it goes, but so far it seems to be okay. It will only really be recognizable or noticed after a few days of use to see what performance is like overall. However, I did run the Geekbench scores on these devices, so let's go ahead and take a look. So if we go to Geekbench on my 12 Pro Max here, you'll see that it came in at 1,589 for single core, 4,058 for multi-core. Now, I ran it a couple times because it was low initially. Generally, after you do an update, it will be a little bit slower. But as you can see here, let's go back to the last time I ran this. Now you can see on June 24th, I've run this twice, and the score is pretty good compared to June 2nd with beta 1. So it increased from the first time I ran it to the second. And again, the same thing you can see from this day, or from today to the next time I ran it. It will improve over the next couple of days, but so far it feels pretty fast. Now let's go ahead and take a look at all of these devices so you can compare with yours. Now, as you can see from left to right, I have the new M1 12.9-inch iPad Pro, then the iPhone 11 in the middle, and then the iPhone 12 Pro Max on the right. And this should just give you a general idea of overall scores. I'll be updating the iPhone 6S Plus with Beta 2 very soon, but I needed a device to compare between different versions. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15 Beta 2? And if you were already on Beta 1, then absolutely go ahead and install it. You'll have a ton of bug fixes, some new features I've mentioned already, and then, of course, as you're experiencing issues or problems, you'll want to report those in the feedback app, as this is not a finished version. And so if you're waiting for a very stable version, I really wouldn't install this yet. I would wait for the public beta to come out, and hopefully we'll have that very soon. Apple said that it would be available in July. Sometimes they are a little bit earlier than that, and if they're going to find out that beta 2 is very stable, then maybe they could release it as soon as early next week. But July is not too far away, so I would expect it fairly soon, at least based on what they said at WWDC, early July, maybe even earlier if this is a very stable version. Now, as far as when to expect the final version, many of you have been asking that, generally around late September when they release the next iPhone, iPhone 13, for example. As far as iOS 14.7 betas, well, I'm surprised we haven't seen beta 4 yet or a release candidate. So look for that very soon, maybe even tomorrow or early next week. And then we'll see that release to the public, with iOS 14 versions coming out until the final release of iOS 15 in late September, like I said. So we should see iOS 14 versions until then. And so there's a ton of changes in this already. A lot of refinements and improvements, but I'll be using it on my main device as well as my iPad. So if I find any other new features, I'll be sure to do a follow-up with all of that information as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.